Hello and welcome to episode 19 of the Beyond Sports Broadband Edition with me, Digvijay Singh Deo. My guest today is an Olympic finalist, a world record holder, one of the pioneers of Indian shooting, and currently she's also a coach with the Indian team. Subhash Hirur, thank you so much for joining me. Now, this lockdown has been a sort of a bittersweet episode for you because you managed to get your son out of Germany on the last available flight, but some part of your family is now stuck in Goa.
Yes, it's been quite a challenge getting the whole family together. But I think eventually we did find our way, and we could I could get my son back here from Germany, and he's quarantined for 14 days and beyond, actually. But and then with the lockdown, thankfully he's hale and hearty, healthy. And yes, my in-laws are in Goa, all safe. So I think so far so good, and I take it positively. And I think the times that we've had through the lockdown is a very valuable family time that I've missed for the past 2 years. So I would say that's the silver lining, apart from the fact that yes, we are here, and the lockdown is not the best thing for a lot of people. I know that.
Yes, because for you, I mean, since you perhaps the Rio Olympics been a very hectic kind of life, as you were telling me when we spoke for this interview, it was what, you've probably never spent more than a week at home.
Yes, absolutely. The last 2 years, especially ever since I took charge of as a high performance coach, I think really has been a roller coaster ride. And the last 2 years have been extremely busy. I haven't been able to spend more than a week at home. So this, I would say, the initial part, at least the first 2 weeks of the lockdown were like a blessing in disguise for me. And it was really a much needed time and rest at home. But I think now the work begins, and we are all getting slightly busier despite the lockdown with all the online interactions we are having with shooters around the country and the online sessions and the online exercise sessions. So I think now we get busier, and finally it's an acceptance that, okay, this is it. We can't just sit down and wait for the lockdown to open up. I think we got to plan and believe that the situation is going to be the same for a long time to come, and we start planning and working ahead.
You know what it takes to compete at the Olympics? Perhaps the sacrifice of what an Indian Olympian goes through is typified by you, because I think your elder son, the one who came back from Germany, was about 2 or 3 years old when you went to Athens, and when you were training abroad, you had to leave him and continue training. So from a sporting point of view, from a sportsperson's point of view, how disappointing has it been for all of you to see the Olympics postponed? I mean, they had no other option, but it must be something which feels wrong.
Yes, I think it's been extremely disappointing. Of course, there was no other choice but to postpone the Olympics, because but it's been disappointing because I think this time, especially with the Olympics, the whole team was extremely well prepared. And after the Rio debacle, I think there were a lot of steps taken, a lot of concrete positive steps. And first time ever, we had an Olympic policy in place, and all the shooters, most of them ranked among the top three in the world. So I think we really had a team, or I would like to say have a team, that is extremely well prepared and ready to win. So I think it's been a little heartbreaking to have the Olympics postponed, not just by 1 or 2 months, but by one whole year. I think that's disappointing, but nevertheless, we accept it. And at the same time, we know that we've had one of the best teams in the world, and we are going to prepare prepare to be the best even 1 year down the line.
No, but Subha, the problem with that statement is that you have one of the best teams in the world. There's no doubting it. You know, we were, in fact, all of us who track Indian shooting were looking at, perhaps we had a chance of 4 to 5, if not more, medals at these Olympic Games. The problem is that it's a very young team. It's a very young team which was headed to its first Olympic Games, barring, say, Rajput or Rahi Sarnobad. Apurvi Chadal had been to the Olympics as well. Most of them were going to their first Olympic Games. I was speaking to Abhinav Bindra a couple of weeks back, and he said that it is for these young shooters that we will have to spend more time in getting them back on track, because they don't know how to react to a situation like this.
Yes, that's true that we do have a young team, and but at the same time, because of the fact that they are young, I think they can be molded and groomed, and you know, we can we are in a position to show them the right direction, and that's the reason we are not letting them be on their own, but we are working together as a unit. In fact, today morning also we had a Zoom online call with all the shooters and along with the coaches and the physios in devising a plan. So we are making sure, yes, they are young. They don't know what to do. They don't know how to handle the situation. I do agree. But at the same time, we are here at, you know, showing them the right direction and making efforts at bringing a plan together so that these young kids are still on track and we continue to work along the same direction, keeping the Olympics 1 year down the line.
See, it's fair you say that, because mentoring is one of the most crucial aspects right now, more than coaching. Coaching can perhaps only happen, and as you're a high performance manager, that can only happen when you're back in the training range. Right now, that's not happening. Mentoring. So how do you ensure all of your, the 15 of the shooters who had qualified for the Olympics, how do you ensure they stay sharp? I think that's more important. Staying sharp and staying mentally fit is perhaps one of the most important tasks right now.
Yeah, so I think that's one of the biggest challenges that the Federation has right now at, you know, making sure that the shooters can continue to maintain their form. And so we've come up with different plans, because everything depends on how, you know, at what pace the outbreak takes, you know, at how it goes, how COVID-19 takes, what direction it takes, and how we are able to flatten the curve. So we have come up with a couple of plans. Plan A is if everything goes off well and hopefully things get better, and by July, August, things open up and we get back on track, but I don't see that happening. And plan B is if the international calendar opens up next year, so, you know, how you and so mainly all the shooters would be working from their houses and from their homes, and the lockdown continues all the way. You know, even if it opens up, there are bound to be restrictions. And the plan C is if the restrictions continue for a long time, say well beyond next year, and the international calendar is still closed, and there's no, you know, we will not be able to have any domestic competitions or international competitions. So I think the most important task right now is to keep the shooters and the coaches and all of us ready for any scenario coming up. And the most important thing would be to devise systems believing that we are going to be in this situation maybe for, you know, the whole year. You don't know. So if it opens up, very well, we are happy and we have a plan in place. But what if it doesn't? So I think the first step in this direction, I think, would be to find a way to have to help each shooter establish a one lane system in their own houses. A lot of them already have it, but some don't. So I think this is the first step, which even the president has been very voices for us about it, that we need to find a way to get the electronic target systems for our Olympic bound shooters so that they find a way to set it up in their houses. And this would be the first step. So,
I just want to interrupt you on that point, because that was leading me to my next question. Not everyone, as you said, has a 10 meter target at home. Some have, some are fortunate enough to have, some don't. And for those people who don't, how difficult is it? Because you can do as much of dry practice or shoot on SCAT, which is a kind of a simulation software, but it doesn't beat, it doesn't compensate for the actual competition, because you need to be able to shoot the pellet or, you know, the ammunition. You need to be able to be in competition as well. We saw some online competitions as well last week, but is that the way to go?
Online competitions are an excellent example of shooters, you know, a way for them to stay competitive. But we can do that only if everyone has a system in their house. And there are so many who don't have a system in their house, or rather who don't have the place to have a system in the house. So that's the biggest challenge, and also the biggest worry, I would say. And yes, you can do wall holding, but for how long? After a particular time, it gets boring. So, you know, it's that's the reason why getting targets, electronic targets, individually for especially our Olympic core group is one of the most important priorities for the federation, and also, you know, and also for the shooters. So I think that's going to be the biggest challenge and our priority right now in ensuring that each one has a target in their house. So, you know, that's what we are working at right now.
Okay. But say, you know, we're looking at perhaps June or even July before all these restrictions about travels and being safe is actually moves into place. Still, the jury's out on that. How long do you think will it take for our shooters to reach their peak again? Because let's face it, not everyone can sustain this all through this period.
Well, I would say that in that matter, there is going to be a big difference between the senior shooters and the junior shooters, because some of our senior shooters really have been into the game for a long time, you know, maybe some even for a period of 10 years, maybe. So they have a very strong muscle memory. And I think for them, it would be a little more easier, and they could be on track a little more faster, maybe, you know, in a period of maybe within a month, you know, I would say that they could really be back on track. But the real challenge would be for the juniors, because first of all, they are into the sport not for too long. And secondly, their bodies are growing, changing. So, you know, they need to adapt to the way their bodies, they grow, especially in terms of their age. So they need to adapt to that along with the long haul of, you know, not shooting. So it's really going to be a challenge for them. But given their talent and their ability, I think with the right guidance, they are definitely going to need a lot of guidance in this direction. So with the right guidance, we do hope to get them on track for, you know, in a matter of 1 or 2 months. But like I said, the most important factor for both, you know, the juniors and the seniors would be, even if your skills are on a standstill, you know, even if you're not able to shoot live, what is important is to keep yourself physically ready. So they need to be physically fit and they need to work on fitness. And this is something that I think anyone and everyone can do at home, thanks to all the online classes going on and also a lot of online stuff that is available nowadays. And kids shooters are very good with technology. And I do hope with whatever space they have, they should be able to keep their bodies fit and physically fit, so that once things ease out a little bit, getting the shooting would be a little more easier if they are physically fit.
No, I think it's also a huge test of our coaches. There's you, there's Samresh Jung, there's Jaspal Rana, Dipali Deshpande. All of you have represented India with distinction. All of you are Olympians as well, because it's, as you said, the younger ones are going to have a problem as well to adjust. But even for the senior ones, I mean, those who've been around for a while, like Apurvi Chandela and Anju Mudgal, won their Olympic tickets in 2018. So by the time they shoot the Olympics, Suma, it's going to be 3 years. And it's very difficult for any shooter to keep a peak up for that long. It's unfair on them as well.
Well, when I talk about these shooters, especially Apurvi, Anjum, and the ones who got their tickets really early, well, I would like to say that in the last 2 years, it's been really, really I would say, very challenging for them to maintain their place, you know, in terms of keeping the quotas. It's been a big challenge. And if they've been able to rise and prove themselves over 2 years in being able to perform at every competition there was and maintain their form despite the huge pressure, I think they've already proved themselves. They've done it for 2 years. They can definitely do it for one more year as long as they have the hunger and the desire and the will to go out there and still win. So all the shooters have proven themselves. So they've done it for 2 years, definitely, you know, I am quite sure they can keep it up for the next 1 year as long as they are physically fit and mentally hungry for a win and on the big stage. So I think
no, but there is the burnout factor as well, no?
I wouldn't like to consider the burnout because, in fact, I would say this is the lockdown period for a lot of the senior shooters would also be a contributing factor in charging themselves. You know, it's the last 2 years have been so hectic. It's been so much competing and the shooters did need this time to recharge and to, you know, rejuvenate themselves and to get back the hunger and also to get maybe fitter to the next level, because the last 2 years have been so busy competing, they've not been able to really up their levels the way they would like to. So I think this could be, you know, if we look at the positive side of things, I think if they take this as a positive time to enhance and enrich themselves, I think it would prove really good for a lot of our shooters.
Okay, as you said, a welcome break for everyone. As it's, you know, this everyone was sort of charging along towards the Olympics, and then we've hit a sort of a circuit breaker. But brings me to my next question. I have been reading in the papers, and I've been speaking to people around shooting as well, that your federation, the National Rifle Association of India, wants to declare the team for the Olympics right now. Do you think it's fair at the moment, with the Olympics 15 months away, with a period of great uncertainty ahead of us, is that the right way to go? 15 months, why can't we wait till perhaps next year? See how the situation evolves.
Well, initially, let's say that even I've been of the opinion that we need to check the latest form and, you know, let's maybe wait for a year. We could have another set of trials before we decide on the team. But looking at the way things are going and looking at the way the curve is going of COVID-19, I think the situation is going to be pretty much the same for a long time. So it really doesn't make sense in having another set of trials maybe next year, because we don't know which shooter is in which situation and, you know, how well they are going to be able to train, how well they are not going to be able to train, we don't know the situation. So I think it would be very unfair. They've done their bit for the last 2 years. They have, they've done full justice to the Olympic policy. And in fact, had it not been for the lockdown, the teams were supposed to be announced on the 21st of March. So, had the teams been announced, then we would have had a team in place. But just because it's not announced, I think and with the situation where we may not be able to hold or host any domestic competitions or forget about the international ones. So in a situation like this, I think it doesn't make sense to just keep things hanging for a year. And what would be important is maybe declare the team and protect them and protect our team and maybe find a way to start training once the restrictions are a little eased out. Find an isolated range with only the Olympic core group shooters are able to train, maintaining the social distancing and the lockdown so-called restrictions that we have. And maybe we could
just on that, just on that, if I could interrupt you, because there have been some developments. And I was speaking to Gopi Chand last week, and he suggested that the ministry should set up a quarantine camp where athletes from across India, the top athletes, say the top 10 athletes in each discipline, are brought in there under supervision and they train. Like you have the hockey team currently in Bengaluru. It's only them inside that big Sai campus. Yesterday, the Indian Olympic Association has also said that we're going to request the government for a quarantine camp for all our Olympic hopefuls. That could be the way to go. Get everyone in together. Let them train. What do you think about that?
Yeah, definitely. That's something that is already making the round. And that's the line along which, you know, all of us coaches are also thinking and along with the federation. And we do believe that in the next couple of months, when things are a little bit easier, we could have a camp in an isolated range where we have only the Olympic bound shooters who are able to train there, of course, after the basic testing and, you know, after checking that the coaches and the shooters are all fit to be part of the camp. And then continue in situation where it is a little bit in isolation, where they can just go from their rooms to the ranges, back to the rooms. And, you know, we could still. But for that, yes, we need to have our team, the core group. It can't be something at a national level or for a large number of shooters. Definitely only the Olympic core group shooters maintaining all the rules. That's something that is something that the federation is working at.
You know, my worry, Suma, is this. We've seen in the past, especially at a time when you all were at your peak back in the last decade, that, you know, you would go to the Olympics, once somebody's got their quota, they would be the one going, and then form goes out of the window. We've had instances in the past when people have gone, they've not been in the best of form, they've gone to the Olympics. I agree that the situation is unprecedented. But we still have time. And I'm coming back to that. Even if the team had been announced, does it make sense to carry the same team for a competition 15 months from now? Why not wait and see how it unfolds? Those who have won the quota, the policy is suspended at the moment. They retain their quotas at the moment. Let's see if the situation changes. Let's see if we can hold the nationals. Let's see if we can, if the NRA can have a couple of domestic tournaments. Not now, but as you said, this isolation camp, if they start, there are Sai campuses where you can hold competitions with, say, 10 air rifle shooters, the top 10 in this country, just to see that we don't send someone to the Olympics whose graph is dipping.
Yeah, see, in this whole conversation, there have been so many let's sees, you know, let's see if this happens, let's see, you know, everything is, we can't have everything hanging, we can't have the whole system hanging on a hope. So, we got to assume, till date, there is no international calendar, we don't know. And so we can't just assume that it might open. So and even if we assume it opens, how many of our Olympic athletes have access to a situation where, you know, they are able to train and maintain their form? Instead of that, so even if we have trials, is it going to be fair for those who have been, who've proved themselves, who've been in the top five in the world for, you know, for the last 2 years, who've already proven themselves, who've fulfilled all the norms for, you know, of the Olympic policy? So would it be fair to just keep them hanging? And because opening up the the number of people who could still vouch for that, for a place in the Olympic team. So with so much of uncertainty, with so much uncertainty, you know, it doesn't make sense that we just keep everything hanging. From what we can see, things there's we can't really have any competitions to through the year where you have more and more people competing. It's not happening. Instead of that, what would make sense is to protect our shooters and ensure that they are able to maintain their form. And I think that's a more concrete solution, and that's a more concrete way to look forward to. So in times of uncertainty in the way COVID-19 is progressing, and in times of uncertainty in every direction, none of us know, neither the ministry, absolutely nobody knows how things are going to turn. So in times of so much uncertainty, I think let's at least have one certainty that this is a team. Let's have one certainty that this is the plan ahead, and at least have one certainty of protecting our team and continuing to train for the next year. So I would rather like to be, you know, have a certain element of certainty when it comes to our Olympic bound athletes.
Suma, we could be in a situation in 2021 where the Olympic shooting program could throw up some very surprising results. Usually, you know which are the shooters who are doing well leading up to an Olympic. So even though shooting is a very precise sport, a sport of perfection, you can't predict results. But you do know who are the shooters who are going to be in the mix. Now that you're not going to have any sort of competition, at least what it looks like this year, you think 2021 Olympics in shooting could throw up some very surprising results?
Yes, maybe we could hope for some surprising results. But like I said, we are not going to have any competitions, international competitions, maybe for a long time. But like I said, we would definitely keep the Olympic bound athletes, the core group especially, on their toes with a lot of competitions within the camps or, you know, online for the core group competitions, and ensure that they are still in their top competing form. And hopefully the results are not too way off as most of us predict. But I do hope that it'll be along the same lines that the team was up to this year, and not just the few who were in the top world ranking, but even the others are able to catch up in the time that we have. The one-year bonus, I think, definitely is a blessing for some of our junior shooters, I think, who are really upcoming and who are really getting on to the higher ranks. And so I think it could also be a blessing, and maybe it could be better than what we had. We were supposed to have it this year. So you don't know how things go. And of course, it's a big challenge on part of the federation and the coaches to ensure that the shooters are motivated and they are still in their competitive best. But of course, we need to find ways, and I think innovation is the key. And hopefully we are able to do that and still manage to stay on top, because this is a situation that is not there only in our country, it's across the world. So not just our shooters, but shooters across the world are hit by this pandemic. So we hope to stay one step ahead with all the plans that we have in place.
Okay, who would have thought, Suma, that a journey to the Olympics is actually a journey into the unknown? A lot of focus is obviously on athletes, but because of what we have seen in the last few months, the role of the coaches is going to be extremely important as well. The role of coaches to be mentors, especially to the Indian shooting team. So it seems like it's going to be a very difficult next 15 months for you and the rest of your coaches. So enjoy this period in lockdown with the family. I think this is going to be the easiest thing right now. Once things open up, going to be extremely more difficult for you and the rest of your colleagues. Thank you so much, Suma, for joining me as always. Lots of unanswered questions, lots of uncertainty, even for us who follow the sport. But nice to get a perspective from you, especially from a coaching perspective.
Thank you so much.